sacadas for followers and leaders, but in line.
Hello everyone, and welcome to Tango at Home.
At the studio for us.
Once more. So before we begin with the class, a big thank you to Entrescolan for supporting our videos, and a big, big thank you to all of you who keep being with us and supporting us with your donations. Rita, what are we going to work today?
Today we are going to work sacadas for followers and leaders, but in line. So let's go.
Let's go.
What we want you to get from today's class is that we don't move on a specific rhythm with the music, or on the beat, or on the double beat, there's nothing. We just move when we feel with the music that it's time to step. The first part is this one. We start from one beat parallel with each other, we lead the cross, pam pam, saccada, and finish. This is the first part. Before proceeding to the second one, be sure that you are comfortable with this. What do we mean with that? This is my direction, and I want when we finish the sequence, you keep looking at the same direction. Now, some tips for the first part. Cross, pam, pam. When you lead the sacada to the follower, leave the place. Lead here behind you. Behind you. Now keep leading the gyro, change weight, read the step of the follower, and go from under. Don't rush to go. From under, pivot the follower, change weight, and again from under. This is my direction. And we finish the first part.
For the followers, things to have in mind. Now, after the cross, when you go for the first sacada, don't be afraid to invade his space, to go where he's actually leading. And also, don't just follow visually where he's going, because this is not what he's leading. Plus, I'm also opening my hips. And I want to step where my hips are pointing. So if my hips are pointing forward, this is where I'm going to step. And the sacada that is leading is where he was previously. And this is where I want to be. Now, for us, it's a sidestep because we are in a giro. So it's forward, I receive the turn, sidestep. And now I continue in a simple turn, which is for a backstep. I receive the rotation, backstep, and we are ready for the final part of the sacada. In this part, what you will receive is that as soon as he's changing the weight, you will feel the motion of going up, there. And in this moment, what I want you to think is to activate your core and don't let your hips collapse and don't sit, okay? From here, I receive and I go up. There.
For the second part, we finish here. And we want to start with only the leaders doing a step. So we disconnect the embrace so that we don't affect the follower. Now we will lead three forward steps for the follower. And on each step there will be a sacada happening. Forward and see there's the sacada. I change. Forward and see there's the sacada. And now we will do the lapis. We will change weight. And on your last forward, we'll go for the final sacada. Pivot the follower, invite her again inside you to do the sacada, ruler here to enter the sacada. And now we are just exactly in the end of the first part. We finish here. So the second part is this one. Boop, and one, and two, and three. Sacada, sacada, and finish.
For the followers, as you might have realized, we are simply doing forward steps. So after I finish the first part, and also don't forget to activate the foot of your free leg. So you want your big toe to point down and to be parallel to your standing leg. Okay, so from here, I will simply receive the leading to a forward step, another forward step, and another forward step. All right, nothing different from here. What we will do then is a pivot, because we're going to pivot, and again a forward step, there, okay? So what makes it a bit hard, it's because he's in front of us, but don't be afraid of following the direction that the leader is giving you. So if he's telling you to go forward, you go forward, with the timing that he's giving you.
The most challenging part is here that followers are afraid to step on the leader, because the leading in the beginning is towards the leader.
Exactly.
So we finish here.
We finish the first part, here we go. Forward, 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 pivot, forward, and then it's again, side, back. So I just want you to really put your effort on receiving the leading and go forward, and don't be afraid of occupying their space.
Now for the last part, we finish again here, the second part, and the beginning is the same, only the leaders, and for the first two steps we invite the follower to the sacadas. Boop and sacada. Now for the third step, we will do a big pivot and we will go with a back sacada. Boom. We pivot here again. So for the follower it's exactly the same steps as before. We are doing something different. We invite you to the sacada here, and we will do an enrosque after this, to go for the gancho. So, invite you for the sacada, keep leading the gyro, but now we are going for the enrosque, and on your side step, we step close to your axis to get the gancho. Here, do a small rebound to get two ganchos. Boom, and boom. And close the follower from behind. So, the third part is like this. We finish here, and forward sacada, leaders, followers, and rows, and ground, and cross.
For the followers, when we are walking forward, make sure that you are not going to fall forward, because what you feel is that he's pulling you towards that direction, so for you to go forward. But don't fall, but also don't stay back to really exaggerate the movement. We will walk forward with their timing, okay? So it's sacada, sacada. Now, to also to put a bit more fluidity in your steps, if you see when I walk forward, can you start? I never stop the movement, I don't go here, and then go there and stop. I make my steps fluid like I would do if I would be a normal walker.
But that comes also from the leading.
Exactly. So, from here.
Because my leading here is constant.
There.
Boom,
there.
Boom,
there.
Boom.
There.
Yes.
Okay, so my forward steps will always be dynamic, because that's also his leading dynamic. Forward and forward and forward and forward. So don't block the movement. Okay.
After we finish the last part, boom, 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 shoot, rock, boom, boom, pop, cross. Then you can actually do whatever you want. This was just a suggestion that you can enter the crossy step, catch your leg, And from after the barrida, you will meet in chair axis. As I lead the follower back, I am approaching chair and we embrace.
And that was all for today. Don't forget, if you like our videos, hit the like button, the subscribe button, and the notification bell to know when we upload new videos. Now, you have a whole week to practice what you learned today, because next Wednesday, Sara and Juanpi will upload a new video with new stuff to practice.
And you don't want to miss it, because it's going to be awesome.
Exactly.
Like always.
Now, before we go to Rita, we want again to say a big thank you to Entre Escolan for supporting our videos, and a big, big, big thank you to all of you for being awesome, for supporting us, and for keeping Tango alive.
What I want to say is that we will start the new courses, the new term, autumn term, on the second week of September. So stay tuned, because we will post all the information about the courses on Facebook by email. So don't miss it.
That was all for today. Enjoy the rest of the summer.
Enjoy life.
Enjoy the beautiful weather and be good and safe. Hey-do!
Hey-do!